Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and before we start the news, a personal note. Obviously, we at KDAB, like everybody, are shocked by the Russian invasion in Ukraine, and we condemn this unprovoked, unlawful war inflicted by the Russian leadership and its helpers. The destruction and suffering for the Ukrainian people seems unbearable, and our thoughts are with you. We wish you the best of luck and strength to withstand aggression and hope that violence and suffering can be stopped as soon as possible. KDAB as a company and KDABians individually are contributing to humanitarian relief efforts where we can. Also, we want to say that many of our partner companies and customers work with developers from both Ukraine and Russia. It is a terrible situation for people who we know and who we value. Take care and stay safe. Now back to the news, where in this edition we have CXX Qt, Rust bindings for Qt, an interview with Andrew Hazen, one of the developers, Squish 7.0 released, tip of the month, and announcements. At KDAB, we have been investigating how to integrate Rust with Qt in a safe and idiomatic way. The solution that's currently being worked on is called CXX Qt. To learn a bit more about it, I speak with one of the involved developers, Andrew Hazen. Hi, Andrew.
Hi, Robert. Thank you for having me.
So, why did you look at Rust bindings for Qt?
We looked at Rust bindings for Qt because Rust has been an emerging language over the past few years, with increased memory safety and still having the performance of languages like C and C++. And it's been increasing in the embedded space, where you want safety in your programs, but you also want performance.
Mm-hmm. Safety and performance. Good things to focus on when dealing with embedded. And where can Rust with Qt be useful?
We feel that Rust with Qt can be useful for the business logic layer of your application, where you tend to be processing unsafe inputs or needing to perform multiple tasks in parallel for multi-threading and things. But we still feel Qt would be good for the UI side. So moving your existing plugins or over to Rust, or making use of the rich ecosystem of Rust libraries, is where we feel it would be useful.
Using Qt to its strengths and reinforcing that with Rust. Good. How does CXX Qt work, and what are the advantages compared to other approaches?
CXX Qt uses a bridge rather than direct bindings in traditional bindings. This allows us to limit the scope and be more restrictive and opinionated. Then we use procedural macros, which allow us to keep an idiomatic API to the Rust side. And then we, by using CXX itself, we remove a lot of the unsafe code that is in other bindings of this type. And this allows us later as well to integrate tightly with existing Rust libraries for serialization and multi-threading going forward.
Excellent. Thank you very much for those answers, and thank you for your time.
Thank you for having me.
If you want to learn more, you can read the blog post linked below, and also meet Andrew at Qt DevCon in June in Berlin, where he is going to give a talk about this topic. Also, if you visit Embedded World, you can visit the KDAB booth to talk to one of our experts. After 6 years, the first major release for the Squish GUI tester has been released. Version 7.0 comes with a bunch of new features, such as video capture of test execution in Squish IDE and on the command line, enhanced platform support, for example, on Apple M1, access to CSS properties for testing web applications, improved JavaScript engine, and enhanced Qt 6.2 support, With version 7.0, Squish will be only available as subscription-based license models. But customers who own a perpetual Squish license continue to get access to Squish 6.7.x and technical support for that. Find more info in the link added below and check out the webinar dates. Writing mobile apps can be a lot of fun, especially with Qt and QML. But if your background is all about C++ and Qt, writing the entire stack required for a mobile app can be hard. Fetching and storing information, adding push notifications, and having to write that with another language and framework might be a challenge. To help you get started, we published a series of blog posts and videos that teach you how to build a simple mobile chat application with push notifications. On the server side, it will have a REST API powered by Qtlist, featuring a database with async communication for storing conversations. Additionally, it will communicate with Firebase to send the notifications. So, go check it out and enjoy building your own app. The preparations for Qt Developer Conference in June in Berlin are moving forward. We are happy to welcome Felgo as a sponsor alongside our main sponsor, the Qt Company, and our contributors. Watch out for the release of the final program by the end of March, and make sure you get your early bird ticket. Keep an eye on qtdevcon.com for more updates and information. On the 29th and 30th of April, the Linux App Summit will happen virtually and in Rovereto, Italy, and the attendance free of charge. The call for proposals will close on the 18th of March, so hurry up if you still want to submit a talk. Registration for participants will open soon. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and, as usual, feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time.